Hello everyone. Today I make cheesy potato bread. No oven needed. If you like to see how I make them, please come to the kitchen with me. Welcome to Sài Gòn Cook Travel. I am Sài Gòn Cook. So first I chop up 5 stalks of chive. I like to get the chive butter for my mashed potato. The mashed potato goes into the stuffing. So assuming that you have mashed potato ready, I use about 300 grams. I have shared with you how to make a super fast mashed potato. If you like to see, if you haven't seen it, please go to my channel and find out. Anyway, I will put the link in the description box below for your reference. Now, I use 2 tablespoons of butter here, and I'm melting now on my skillet, and I will add chive to this. You can get it going until it's golden brown. At this point, the maximum aroma will be, but I kind of like to keep the green color, so when my butter melting, that's what I'm remove from the heat. After I remove from the heat, I will add into my mashed potato. My recipe today is only for 2 pieces of bread. So I use only 300 grams of mashed potato. And another component is cheese. So I have cheddar cheese and mozzarella. For cheddar cheese, I use the yellow singles and the block. For the mozzarella, I use the block and the shredded. If you like, when you cut it or you break your bread, the cheese will ooze out and string. That's what you looking for. Then you add more cheese. Here I add the 1 piece of single, a piece of cheddar, a piece of mozzarella, and about 2 tablespoons of shredded mozzarella cheese. I love to grow potato. The first time that I fell in love with it, when I travel in the cold country and stop at that neighborhood, and people offer me young potatoes steamed in chicken stock, drizzled with sage butter. Wow, I fell in love since then, and I try to grow them. But until now, I'm not successful with potato gardening. Last time when I was in North Carolina, it's so hot, my potatoes died. Now I am in Florida. The temperature seems fine to me, but on the rabbits, destroy my potato, so I'm not successful yet. But luckily now is holiday season and the stores put on sale a lot of potato. So I bought 10 pound bags. That one, you know, I have potato 7 ways now. So far, I share with you how to make mashed potato super fast, super easy. And then I share with you the cheese, potato cheese buns. And today, potato cheese bread. So, for the bread part, you need to have the proof bread dough. I made it in advance, I don't show here, but if you want to see how I make bread, how to mix the dough for the bread, I will put the description box below the link for you to be referred. So I continue stuff my bread now. Remember the size. You can see the you saw my skillet about 5 inches. So that's why I spread my flour 5 inches plus 4 inches outside of the stuffing, so that I have some dough left over, so that I wrap around. You can see that I wrap around so that my stuffing neatly sit inside. Because if you don't, when you go cook them, they will ooze out. It's not the bad thing, but it's not look a round shape anymore. So this is my skillet, and I make the bread piece sit snugly on into the skillet. But it's up to you. It depends on your skillet, or you can make the individual small. You can do so. But when you do so, please make sure that your bread dough wrap on around the stuffing. So I cook on medium heat. You don't want too hot to burn your bread, and you don't want too low. It won't it don't make golden brown for you. So I cook 3 minutes each side, and now you can see I use the help of the plate and flip it over. You can see the bottom golden brown. Now I just need to cook the other side. I use a piece of foil to help my to help me cover neatly. Now you can flip it by just using chopsticks, or you can flip like a professional chef. I did that before, but I'm afraid now. This time I had make only 2 pieces of bread. I'm afraid I mess with 1 or 2, and then I don't have any products to show you. So I don't flip. I use the chopsticks, and I use the plate to flip my bread. Now it's done. You can see it's so fast, and it's golden brown. And you can see on my bread, some of the cheese ooze out. That because I wrap not so carefully, but it's okay. It will make more attraction. When you see that, you will know that, oh, if you break it, it will cheesy and oozing out. All right, now I will cut the bread to show you about the cheese. You for keep watching me, and I like to take opportunity to say thank you for stopping by watching my video. If you're new to my channel, please like, share, and subscribe. That show your support to me. You are the reason I'm here. If I know anything, I will share here with you. So please subscribe. All right, here you can see the cheese string out with that stuffing. If you want more cheese, by all means, you can stuff more cheese in it. Well, I hope you like my video. Please come back to see other videos. Thank you. Bye-bye.